It's Sarah, your other biology professor, and we need to talk about transcription, prokaryotes versus eukaryotes, because we love writing exam questions that compare those groups. Spoiler, here's the categories that we're going to be looking at. Let's break them down. Transcription is making RNA from a DNA template, so it'll happen where the DNA is. In prokaryotes, there's no membrane separating the DNA from the rest of the cell, so transcription will occur in the cytoplasm. Whereas in eukaryotes, DNA is in the nucleus, and that's where you'll see the process happening. And for some bonus points, a little bit of compartmentalization. Genes encoding ribosomal RNAs, rRNAs, are found in the nucleolus, so those genes will be transcribed there. And mitochondria and chloroplasts have their own genomes as well. Transcription will happen there too. Lots of similarities to bacterial transcription, but less well understood. So when we're talking about eukaryotic transcription here, I'm going to be referring to transcription of genes in the nucleus. And those nuclear genes are going to be packaged up by proteins, histones, inside the nucleus. And those will have to be moved or modified in order to make the DNA accessible to the eukaryotic transcriptional machinery. Whereas prokaryotes rely more on twisting in order to package their DNA, so not a lot of need to move proteins around there. And what kinds of RNAs are we transcribing? Well, prokaryotes have a much smaller set that they make, while eukaryotes transcribe all your favorites, messenger, transfer, ribosomal, and many, many more. And the enzyme responsible for transcribing these RNAs? RNA polymerase. Prokaryotes have a single type of RNA polymerase that transcribes all their types of RNAs. It's a large 5-subunit enzyme that combines with an additional protein called the sigma factor or specificity factor. That's going to allow it to bind to the promoter to initiate transcription. Different sigma factors are used in different environmental conditions in order to initiate transcription of the appropriate genes. But eukaryotes distribute that workload to at least 3 different RNA polymerases. The one you're most likely to study? RNA polymerase 2. It transcribes the protein coding genes, the ones that make mRNA, and it's the best studied, best well-characterized RNA polymerase in eukaryotes. But regardless of where the DNA is or what kind of RNA we're transcribing or what polymerase is doing it, we need some DNA to be our template for transcription. We need a gene. And a key part of that gene will be its promoter, where transcription is initiated. Promoters are all going to have important signal sequences for proteins to bind. Prokaryotic promoters are less complex than eukaryotic promoters. There's really just 2 major signals. They're also more conserved, meaning there's less diversity in the sequence from one organism to the next. Meanwhile, eukaryotic promoters are more complex and more diverse. They're going to be bound by different RNA polymerases and different sets of proteins. The protein coding genes will have a core promoter. This is the minimum sequences required to initiate transcription. So you'll see the transcription start site as well as places for RNA polymerase 2 and its associated transcription factors to bind. Now, once transcription has been initiated, the next phase, elongation, building our RNA strand, is pretty similar between prokaryotes and eukaryotes. But when it comes to termination, we're going to see some differences again. Prokaryotes have 2 categories of termination based on whether or not a protein called rho or the rho factor is involved. In rho-independent termination, no protein involved here, a sequence is transcribed that produces a hairpin in the RNA transcript, leading to destabilization of the transcriptional machinery. And in rho-dependent termination, here we're going to see that rho protein binding to the transcript, moving along the transcript until it encounters RNA polymerase and stops transcription. Meanwhile, eukaryotic transcriptional termination is less well understood and looks different for different types of genes and different RNA polymerases. Termination of transcription for many protein coding genes involves the transcription of a signal leading to cleavage, cutting of the transcript, and degradation of the extra piece of the strand, along with some modifications of that transcript that we'll see in just a little bit. And while we're talking about these protein coding genes, of course, the next step for our mRNAs is going to be translation, using the mRNAs to build polypeptides. And that process happens in the cytoplasm. That means that in prokaryotes, transcription and translation happen in the same space. And in fact, these processes are coupled in prokaryotes. They happen at the same time. So before transcription is even complete, a ribosome has already hopped on that mRNA and started to translate it. That's not the case in eukaryotes, where the mRNAs have to be completely transcribed and more before they can be exported from the nucleus into the cytoplasm for use in translation. Okay, wait, completely transcribed and more? That's right. In eukaryotes, transcription does not produce a fully functional, ready-to-go RNA. We've got some modifications we need to make, and this is called RNA processing. The processing is different for different types of RNAs, but for mRNAs, or pre-mRNAs, as we might call them before they've been processed, this would include adding a guanine cap to the 5' end of the pre-mRNA. This process happens early in transcription. Adding a 3' poly A tail to your pre-mRNA. This process is tied to transcriptional termination. And splicing, removal of sequences that don't code for amino acids, intervening sequences or introns, and sticking together the ones that do, the exons. And after all of that, you have a mature mRNA ready for translation. These sorts of extensive changes aren't seen in prokaryotes. Remember, transcription and translation are happening at the same time, so there's not much time for processing. All that processing will be useful for eukaryotic translation, but it also makes the mRNA more stable. In fact, eukaryotic mRNAs have a much longer lifespan than prokaryotic mRNAs. That prokaryotic mRNA probably encodes multiple proteins. Most do. We call this a polycistronic mRNA. You see this a lot with operons, where genes are set up back to back and transcribed as a single mRNA. Meanwhile, eukaryotic mRNAs are largely monocistronic, encoding a single polypeptide. But eukaryotes have still figured out how to get multiple proteins from a single RNA transcript through the process of alternative splicing, where different combinations of introns and exons remain in the mature processed mRNA, leading to different combinations of amino acids adding during translation. Do you know another difference between prokaryotic and eukaryotic transcription? If so, drop it in the comments. Otherwise, give me a thumbs up if this was helpful. Subscribe for even more biology content from me and check out my website for tutoring resources. And I will see you next time. Bye.